This episode is brought to you by Squarespace. The world's tallest tree reaches 380 feet into the sky. One giant sequoia is made of enough wood to fill a 747. One baobab tree in South Africa is so wide that they put a pub inside of it. These enormous trees might be rooted in the ground, but almost all of their physical mass grows out of the air. A tree's dry weight, all the leaves, branches, and trunks, xylem and phloem and chloroplasts, are all built from carbon dioxide. Even the water they hold was once water vapor that fell as rain. Trees eat air and turn it into more tree.
Plant a tree for your tomorrow.
Planting trees might be a way to combat climate change, an easy way of sucking excess carbon out of the air. If every person alive planted one, that'd be more than 7 billion new trees. But is that a lot or not? How many trees are there on Earth? Figuring out how many trees there are on Earth sounds like a simple question, but it's surprisingly difficult to answer. I mean, we can't exactly go out and count them all.
1,725.
Dang it! But it's an answer that scientists need to know. Not only are trees an important part of the carbon and water cycle, 80% of terrestrial species call them home, as do 300 million people. 1.6 billion people rely on forests for their livelihood. They control erosion, filter groundwater, and provide raw materials for everything from paper to log cabins, even IKEA furniture.
Trees are terrific!
Until this year, our best estimate for Earth's tree population was around 400 billion, or about 60 trees for every person. But this was based on satellite imagery estimates, which is kind of like trying to count the hairs on someone's head from on top of a skyscraper. In 2015, scientists gathered 500,000 measurements of tree density on the ground from every continent on Earth besides Antarctica. Spoiler, not known for their trees down there. To create a global map of forest trees, stretching across jungles, deserts, grasslands, tundra, everything. This new estimate puts the number of trees on Earth at, get this, 3 trillion. That's unbelievable. That's almost 10 times higher than previous estimates, more than 420 trees for every human. Now, whopping 43% of those trees are in tropical and subtropical regions, the most biologically diverse ecosystems on land. But they're also among the most threatened. Tens of thousands of years ago, before humans conquered Earth, our planet had twice this many trees. Today, deforestation to make way for agriculture, mining, and urbanization continues to erase trees from the map. 17% of the Amazon has disappeared in the past 50 years. Sumatra has lost 85% of its forests.
Nobody cares for the woods anymore.
All in all, we're losing about 48 football fields of forest every minute. 15 billion trees per year. Fewer trees can also lead to less rain. Trees, like all plants, lose water through pores in their leaves in order to cool off and to move nutrients upward from the roots and trunk. As a result, forests create massive clouds of water vapor that condense and fall back down as rain. It's a nice cycle of water in, water out. But cut down the forests, and droughts and fires may take that rain's place. Scientists think maybe 15% of all greenhouse gas emissions have come from deforestation. To put it simply, where there's more trees, there's less carbon in the air. Plus, it looks nice. And there's more shade, there's more places to put hammocks, and rope swings, and tree houses. It's a win-win-win. Win-win. So, there you have it. Earth's tree population counted one twig at a time. With 3 trillion trees on Earth, planting a few billion more might seem like small potatoes, but even one tree can be quite the seed for tomorrow. Stay curious. It's Okay to Be Smart is supported by Squarespace. If there's an idea or a project that you're itching to show the world, well, you should. Squarespace provides tools that help people showcase their passions with a customizable landing page, website, or online store. They also offer domains, hosting, and customer support. Start your trial today by visiting squarespace.com/okaytobesmart or click the link down in the description. Hey guys. So PBS Digital Studios has a ton of great channels all over YouTube, and I hope that you watch all of them. But we want to know more about you, about who you are, what you like to do online, what you like to watch, and what you'd like to watch more of. So we put together a little survey. You'll find a link down in the description. It should just take a few minutes of your time and it would help us make better videos for you in the future. 25 random lucky participants in that survey are gonna get some sweet PBS Digital Studios merch in the form of super styling t-shirts. I have a couple myself. They're like my favorite t-shirts. So thanks again, and we'll see you next week. Stay curious. Let's face it, in the world of physics, Einstein is like Beyonce, Kanye, and Taylor Swift all rolled into one. And a touch of Lady Gaga in the hair. He's famous, but he's got the skills to back it up. By age 26, Einstein had already completely changed physics, but who would be satisfied with that? He still wanted to integrate gravity into his theory of relativity. Einstein's idol, Isaac Newton, had claimed gravity was mediated by an attractive force between two bodies, and that an object that feels no force will either remain motionless